Gynecologic oncology is a very rewarding subspecialty in that we take care of patients longitudinally. That is, once they have a gynecologic cancer, they're always a gynecologic cancer patient. So our specialty is largely surgical. We operate a lot on patients with ovarian cancer and cancer lining of the uterus and so on. But we also give chemotherapy and we take care of them through all of these complications. And then should, God forbid, the cancer recur, we take care of that and help them through the end of life. And I think it's a very rewarding experience, if you will, to be able to, it's an honor really to take care of a patient during this part of their life. We typically explain treatment options to the patient from what we would consider to be the best to the worst or least effective, which might be observation. Some patients choose that. You know, a 60-year-old woman is going to choose something different than a 95-year-old woman, for instance. 60-year-old woman's going to be able to tolerate a big surgery more readily or easily than the 95-year-old. We have a floor that's pretty much dedicated to the care of women with these cancers, and nurses trained to do that. That means then that our service, if you will, even though this place is huge and is intimidating really for patients coming from the outside into Washington University, into the medical center, they will really be on a small floor of about 30 beds of women who have problems just like theirs. The nice thing about Washington University is that no matter where, who you consult or what service, you're almost always getting world-class care. And so, you know, like you could say Dave Mutch is a great GYN oncologist, but I'm only as good as all the people around me, and everybody around me is really good, including the nurses and the house officers and the consultative services, such that, you know, we can provide really world-class care.